like to call Tossy Titan.
Good afternoon. My name is Tossy Titano and I am a junior. The project that I did today was about the old man and the sea, and it is a story about a man named Santiago who went out fishing. He stayed in the ocean for about 3 days and he caught a marlin but returned with nothing because of sharks. The model, I did a clay model, first using clay, the cardboard, and watercolor. Here I have a display of the island of Cuba, his house, and then the old man in the ocean. This is a picture of a display of the marlin that he caught out at sea. And you cannot see it because it's not clay, but the watercolor it has a picture of birds. It reminds Santiago that he is not alone out at sea. And I couldn't have done this with the help of my parents, Jessica and Anthony Marcinez. Thank you.
Thank you, Tossy. Now to sing another song, I'd like to call Scott Salso.
Lonely ocean, I was watching him pulling me. I was thinking about how big that fish was. He just kept on going on. While I was using all my strength, he was using all his tools to work at a pier. When only was here, my job would be a lot easier. Down. Oh, I just wished he would jump soon. I can see what I'm up against. It was perfectly clear. He didn't want to be near me, so I guess I have to wait until dawn. Oh, I was trying my best to catch him, but he never gave up on me. When he jumped and he jumped, I said to myself, oh, what a fish this can be. It was him, 6 fathoms down. Imagine him in my arms, the look on my face when I caught him somewhere in some shadowy place. It was him, 6 fathoms down.
This project here, this man, is Santiago, and this is the Martin that he caught, and that's the harpoon, and this is Cuba. You can see the coconut trees, and this is his shack. This thing here is the dock. So this is based on the old man and the sea. Thank you. Now for a little bit of poetry, I'd like to call Gianna Hoko. Thank you, Denise.
Okay, I wrote this poem for my project, The Old Man and the Sea. Okay, here I go. He is wrinkled, he is old, he is a man who is very cold. He smelled like fish and is very poor. He slept in a house which had no floor. He loved the sea, which didn't give him fish. He is unfortunate and still hungry for fish. A voice stood by him and always seemed secure. He gave him sardines and he made it fair. The boy wanted to follow, but the old man said no. I felt sorry for the boy who wanted to go. The old man by himself, alone in the sea. This poem I wrote is The Old Man and the Sea. The story is great, lots of interesting stuff, but still this poem isn't to tell enough. He dreams of places he wanted to see, and of course about the great whale, which is the name he called the sea. He eats white turtle eggs and drinks shark liver oil. I wonder if that will give him a boil. He eats it for strength and drinks it for good eyesight, but still he was lonely, no one by his side. This is the guy who loved the sea. Santiago is his name, that is the man of the sea. Thank you.
Thank you, Jim. Now, to bring out the artist of our class, I would like to call Roger Saban to display his drawing of the characters.
Good afternoon. Sup, folks. What I did for my project was I did a drawing for the old man in the sea. As you can see over here, the old man, and the background is the sea. And over here is Madeline. And the fish, there's the marlin, the shark, the turtle, DiMaggio, who was a famous baseball player at the time, and the shark. The materials I used was paper, crayons, paper pen, color pencil, watercolor, and all sorts of art materials. While reading, it made me imagine all of these characters in the story. And yeah, it's always useful to use your imagination when you sing by art. And it wouldn't be possible to encounter a task without using your imagination. So yeah, this is my project. Thank you.
Roger. Now to share another singing performance, I'd like to call Stephen Mesta.
The song that we're gonna perform for you guys is a song based on the story Old Man by the Sea. So it's kind of like Latin music. Thank you.
Santiago is his name, and caught a fish, that's a shame. Went out to sea with his little boat, he's not the other man knows. Eyes blue like the cloudy skies, skies will never tell a lie. Life is busy for him these days, sitting down in his old chair, under the sun outside the shack. When it's night, then he'll come in to have a little snack. In bed, the dream came about the lions on the sand, on the beach of Africa, but he's still in Cuba. Bad luck always come and go. In 4 days, the fish will show. Big heart from a little friend, he's known as man who lived. On the very next day, he goes out to sea, to the open sea, leaving his friend waiting for a catch. The line begins to move, tries to pull it in, the strength he will prove. Long days and lonely nights, but the old man won't give up his fight.
One of the animals the old man has seen like to call Oliver Magonia.
Hi and good afternoon. For this enrichment project, I chose to do a research on the Portuguese man of war. In the story, the old man in the sea, Santiago hated the Portuguese man of war. He loved to see them being eaten by large sea turtles. This demonstrates his hate towards the animal, for every time he touches them, they gave him sores. There are over thousands and thousands of creatures in the sea. Some are friendly, some are dangerous. A good example is the Portuguese man of war. The Portuguese man of war is a jelly-like marine animal. Its unique characteristics makes the man of war a feared and dangerous animal. The Portuguese man of war, also called Fecilia Fecilia, is a member of the kingdom Animalia, belonging to the class Hydrozoa in the phylum Cnidaria. The Portuguese man of war is not actually a jellyfish, but it's actually a colony consisting of four different types of polyps, a nematophore or flow, a dactylozoids, which have cells called nematocysts, Nematosis release toxins into anything it comes in contact with, and the gastrozoites or feeding tube, which attaches to its victim and spread over it, and a gonozoid, which produces gametes for reproduction. The man-of-war floats in a gas-filled bladder. The bladder of the body may be 3 to 12 inches long and may be pink, blue, or purple in color. It contains the rare gas called argon. The crest, which is located on top of the bladder, is only a few inches tall and acts like a sail, which catches the wind, moving the man-of-war across the sea. Below the bladder are long tentacles that may grow over 100 feet long. The different polyps support these tentacles. The tentacles are armed with thousands of explosive poison-injecting cells called nematosis. When injected, the nematosis disables the small fish or the man-of-war spray. The poison secreted by the cell is similar to the venoms of other animals. The mixture of neurotoxin is about 75% as powerful as a cobra's venom. This poisonous animal earns its name man-of-war because it is shaped and resembles a Portuguese battleship with a sail. The Portuguese man-of-war may be found floating in warm tropical and subtropical waters such as along the Florida Keys and Atlantic coast, the Gulf Stream, the Gulf of Mexico, the Indian Ocean, and the Pacific Ocean. They are most often seen in the warm waters of the Sargasso Sea. The Portuguese man-of-war travels along in groups of up to 1,000 or more individuals. The Portuguese man-of-war also can be found floating near the surface of the water and can be found stranded along beaches, which are dangerous to humans if they come into contact with each other. The Portuguese man-of-war has a diet which includes young and small fishes, shrimps, crustaceans, and other small animals. Almost all of its prey is fish. The tentacles or dactylozoids are very important to the man-of-war for catching its prey and helping as a defense against larger fishes. The food of the man-of-war is digested in the bag-like stomach called gastrozoites. The gastrozoites help by secreting enzymes which help break down proteins. The proteins nourish the man-of-war and flows to the different polyps of the colony. The Portuguese man-of-war has little natural enemies. An enemy such as the Nummius grondvi, which is a fish, feeds and lives in the tentacles of the animal. Another one of its enemies is the loggerhead turtle, which feeds and preys on the man-of-war. The Portuguese man-of-war is a colony of unisexual organisms. Each individual has specific sex organs, or gonozoids. The Portuguese man-of-war is dioecious, meaning that their larvae develop quickly. Fertilization occurs in open water. The more individuals they are, fertilization will be more successful. Most reproduction occurs in falls, producing many young, especially seen during winter and spring. If stranded in a shore, a Portuguese man-of-war stinging cell remains active even though it is dead. Therefore, it remains hazardous to human beings, especially children. If they come into contact with each other, the stinging cells are then injected into the skin. As a result, the victim may encounter fever, shock, as well as heart and lung problems. The Portuguese man-of-war is one of the many dangerous creatures of the sea. Its abilities and habits makes this animal unique and extraordinary. Although it is dangerous, it should be respected and left unharmed. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Oliver. Now I'd like to call upon Samlin Atelier to share her model display.
Good afternoon. First of all, my name is Samlin Atelier, for you who don't know me. Okay. And for this, okay. I'm doing a model of the old man in the sea. And I don't know what to say. Okay, as you can see, the booth surrounding here represents the ocean. And here's the boat that Santiago used to go out to sea. And this white dude here is Santiago. And the marlin. Okay. And the fishing pole that he used to for the marlin or to catch fish. But someone broke one, so I can't show you the other ones. And I think that's all. Thank you. Now to share a song performance I like to call Mario Special.
Santiago.
Early morning, he wakes up and goes out to sea feeling lucky. Manolin helped him, got him big, which really helped him out. Yeah, he wished he's lucky, old man by the sea. And they say he's unlucky, he's allowed, but he tries to catch the big marlin. Finally caught it, but then the bitch jumped in and left him nothing but shame. Fought the marlin till next day, but there's no one there to help him out. Now he wished the boys there to give him a hand, but too bad there's nothing to give him. Yeah.
Now for another song performance I'd like to call Roger Stavanger.
Me again. The song is about, the old man in the sea. And the title is Go Wherever You Go. Actually, I'm not much of a singer, but it's always good to try something, face your fears. And my band members, the guitarists are Scott and